morning, Hoosier Memorial, and to our live stream viewing audience. Our inspirational nugget for this week is entitled, Sorrows Becomes Joy. Sorrow becomes joy. Our scripture reading comes from John chapter 16 and verse 16. Let us listen for God's word. In a little while, you won't see me anymore. But a little while after that, you will see me again. The word of God. Here Jesus was looking beyond the present century to the new period that would come, my friends. He used an image that was deeply rooted in the Jewish mind. They believed that at all time was divided into two parts, the present time and the time to come. The present was altogether bad and subject to damnation. The time that would come would be the golden age, the time of God. The time between was called the time of the Messiah. Jesus knew the scriptures and he knew about these images. He said to his disciples, I am leaving you now, but I will come back again when my kingdom comes and I start to rule. Before this, however, you will have to suffer hard times. Jesus went ahead to outline all that the Christian would have to endure. There would be times when Christians would experience sorrow, but their sorrow would be changed to joy. And the day would come for a turnabout. The world's reckless joy would change to sorrow, and the Christian's apparent sorrow would change to joy. Christians should always remember this when their faith is costing them. There are two exceptional things about Christian joy. First, it can never be taken away because it is rooted in God. For this reason, this joy will be complete while there is always something missing in the pleasure the world knows. Second, the sorrow that went before Christian joy is forgotten like a mother forgets labor pains. Like the martyr forgets their suffering in the glory of heaven. Robert Browning said, desire joy and thank God for it. Renounce it if need be for others' sake. That's joy beyond joy. Holy Lord Jesus, thank you for the lasting joy that you give to us. Amen.
You gave me my hands to reach across lands to show them your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ears. I can hear your voice so clear. I can hear the cries of sinners, but cannot wipe away their tears. Give me my voice to speak your word, to sing all your praises to those who never heard. But with my eyes I see a need for more availability. I've seen hearts that have been broken, so many people to be free. Lord, I'm available. I'll do what you say to use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to say, giving back to you all the tools you gave to me.
My hands, my ears, my voice, my eyes, to confuse them as you please. I have built it up like gold so that you
be more available to you. Lord, I'm available to you.
My will
I give to you. I'll do what you say to use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to sing. My storage is empty and I am available to you. Storage.